What if you were working on a puzzle of a beautiful scene, but the key pieces were missing?
That would make it really hard to complete the puzzle.
Now, what if lives depend on you having all the pieces to the puzzle?
Well, that would not be good.
Exactly, but 75% of roadway fatalities in the US are roadway departures or happen at intersections. And one key to reducing many of those crashes is friction.
Right, and did you know that on a section of road with all other factors being equal, the lowest friction levels are on curves and approaches to intersections, right where high friction values are needed most.
So how do you know if a particular roadway has adequate friction?
There are many factors that need to be considered, and one of those is to measure the friction of the entire roadway. Now here's the problem. The typical method of measuring friction on roadway networks in the United States only takes sample data. Those samples are generally not taken on curves or at intersections.
So there are important gaps in the data. You can't complete a puzzle with missing pieces, and you can't evaluate friction accurately with missing data.
Luckily, there is now a way to know what friction exists on every foot of your roadways. It's called Continuous Pavement Friction Measurement, or CPFM. Like the name says, CPFM provides continuous data, including locations most vulnerable to friction loss. No gaps. CPFM equipment can measure pavement friction through tangents, curves, and intersections at speeds as high as 50 miles per hour. There's no roadway closures or delays.
Once you know where the problems really are, you can target investment to those locations with confidence. You can also include friction as a parameter in road safety performance modeling. In other words, add CPFM friction data to your crash and other data, and you have all the pieces to your safety puzzle. Spoiler alert, it's a picture of you saving lives.